Live in studio is Hip Hop Nation, your tour guide, Torrey. Hannah Rat is here. Mickey Fax is here.
Yes, sir.
What up, homie?
I'm good, man.
Been a minute since I saw you, man, and it's great to see you in this capacity. A lot of records coming out, man. A lot of things flying around. Bars going crazy,
yes,
you know what I'm saying? And we got the achievement on deck, man.
Yes, Friday, man. The achievement come out tomorrow, 12 a.m., man. I'm excited. Debut album, man.
No doubt.
8 years working on this, man.
Right, so let's just start right there, man. You know, what was... Because... So let's rewind the whole thing. You guys know Mickey. I mean, you seen him in Honda. Was it a Honda commercial?
Honda commercial.
You seen him on the cover of XXL, all over the place. Definitely one of the guys who was in a position and poised to, like, blow big. Like, your cover was, B.O.B., Wale,
Cudi.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
Currency.
Guys who went on to be huge, huge, impactful artists in the music. And you was right there. You was right in the conversation. You was right there.
Mm-hmm.
Talk to me about what took place in the time from that to 8 years later coming with a debut album.
I mean, a lot of it had to do with politics within the label system. You know what I'm saying?
You signed a Jive, right?
Yeah, I was signed to Jive, and then Jive folded. So when Jive folded, like, everybody kind of got lost in the sauce. So it just wasn't Mickey Fax.
Right.
It was like Justin Timberlake and Usher didn't have anywhere to go. So when I got moved to RCA, you know what I'm saying, that A&R system and the people there didn't really know me and wasn't connected to me. So I kind of got lost in the shuffle. And then I was like, listen, I need my Walker papers. I'm out of here. And I left, you know what I'm saying? I left with all my masters or everything, you know what I'm saying? And then it was just a hard climb back, you know, from quitting and then coming back and then just being like, okay, I need to link up with somebody that believes in what I'm doing. Shout out the Knots, shout out the War Media. You know, they came and supported me, and we here today, man. You know, and I'm excited, man. I'm very excited.
Absolutely. And it's good to see, man. You and Knots. That when I saw that, I was like, okay, that should definitely be interesting, man. How did you and Knots link up?
I went on his Instagram. He had 20 LPs and EPs, and I was like, man. I went right on his page and said, yo, what can I do to be on this list? And he DM'd me immediately, and he sent me some beats. And then, like, a week and a half later, I had about 5 joints done.
Crazy.
And then we just kept working like that. I would go on his page and say, I want this beat. And then when I would get the beat, I would see the comments and what they would say. And they'd be like, yo, I hear Currency on this. I hear Fonte on this. And I would reach out to
those. And then you start reaching out.
Yep. And then that's how I made the projects and the songs, you know what I'm saying? So from that, it just turned into something very cohesive between a lyricist / artist and a great, great producer. You know
what I'm saying? Knots is definitely the truth. And he's definitely produced some of your favorite records and worked with everybody from Ye to Wayne to, I mean, the list goes on and on and on. He knows and worked with everybody very, very much a part of Busta Rhymes' initial sound and all that. Mickey Fax is here. Hip Hop Nation Achievement is coming this week.
Yes.
If you don't know about it, we're going to get you all the way caught up. From you having, you know, your footing in the business for so long and grinding to now finally dropping your debut project, man. What are you looking forward to? What are you expecting from it? Like, how does, I mean, because everything changes from this point on, but how does it change for somebody who's kind of already done some of the things and already been here?
This is the debut, so it just feels good to get this weight off my shoulder.
Mm-hmm.
Then we're gonna come back around like in another 3-4 months, man. We're gonna keep doing this. Like, it's gonna be a constant thing for me now that I've got my feet wet and understand how to move when it comes to official projects coming out. Now it's not gonna stop, you know what I'm saying? And we're just gonna continue to flood and flood and flood. But I'm very, very excited for this to finally be done and ready to come out. And I feel like, you know, just putting together 10 songs with one person to have that cohesive sound is something that feels right to me. I went back to my roots with this project just in terms of lyricism and being a, you know, true artistry, you know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
So I'm excited, man.
I mean, you was always a super dope MC. You started making music that, I mean, you were one of the first, dare I say, one of the first guys who really, when the blog stopped popping and people started to understand how to use the blogs and turn them into the new A&Rs and, you know what I'm saying? Like, that was the new mixtape. You was definitely at the forefront of that whole thing and that whole just people popping offline.
Yeah, I couldn't afford DJs. You know what I'm saying?
Like, shit got crazy. Now people can't afford blogs.
Right.
Look how things come in circle.
Yes, I couldn't afford to get on mixtapes. So the blogs were the only place that I could go and give them music. And I just continuously gave them music. And it was like a synergy, you know what I'm saying? And I was experimenting with different sounds as well as just the fashion and then, you know, with just constantly doing it. So I wasn't just rap. I was also getting fly, and then just spreading, you know, different sounds and doing different things so people could be like, okay, he does this. And then I did the acting, and then I did this, you know what I'm saying? So it was like, oh, okay, he's a complete person slash artist slash whatever, you know what mm-hmm. I'm saying? So, you know, I'm just happy that I'm still here 8 years later.
Absolutely. You know, do you feel like, because when you came out, you was really being expressive and really being a true artist, but sometimes the audience doesn't want that, or they don't understand that, you know what I'm saying? They want you to stay in that same space they found you in, you know what I'm saying? Like, how you feel like the people reacted to you really venturing out and being a full artist and being who you are?
At first, I think when I first came out, I was sampling NERD beats.
Mm-hmm.
So I kind of stepped out already to the left.
Mm-hmm.
So it was like, oh, this guy's to the left already. So you can only keep going left. So it was like, I'm going to keep going left. When I started to go right, which was doing the hip hop stuff, people were like, wait, I didn't know you could rap like this. But I'm from the Bronx, and it was just like, this is what I came up doing. I'm a fan of the 80s and the 90s lyricism, but I also understood the youth is what drives the culture continuously and True constantly indeed. You know what I'm saying?
True indeed. Speaking of Pharrell, I know you know the Old City Chess Club. What's going on with that?
I think it's defunct.
Okay.
You know, Lupe tried to put me in charge of it, and you know, I reached out to everybody, but the only person I think that can get it together is Pharrell, and I haven't spoken to Pharrell in a while, so I think that's kind of, it's over. You know what I'm saying?
Gotcha.
I mean, I shouted them out at the Lupe show that I was just at, and I performed, but there's nothing going on with that right now, sadly.
Do you think that when, you know, because when your buzz is all the way up and it's super high and everybody's on it, your phone is always ringing, you know what I mean? It's always popping, your email's always full. And then once it starts to quiet down a little bit, man, do you find that you lost a lot of the people that you felt like might have been in your corner, been around you, or, you know what I'm saying? Or what are your relationships like? Everything's still intact?
Most of them are still good. I try not to burn bridges and try to rub people the wrong way. I mean, I have, but for the most part, I try to be very, very cool with everybody, because you just never know. Like, I try not to turn down people for features, because you just never know. Like, you never know.
Nah,
there's a couple
absolutely.
Of people that I turn down features for that are superstars now. Like, serious superstars.
I'm pretty sure. We was in that same time period, right? And we was getting the same emails, and we might have been hotter than somebody at a particular moment that might be untouchable right now.
Untouchable.
I go through my email every once in a while and just look at it like, you ain't even replied, dog.
There was one. I was like, how did this happen? I just was like, you know what I'm saying? So I try to be very cordial and very nice to every, because you just never know.
Somebody absolutely.
Pop at this.
And everything happens for a reason, man.
Yes,
your story and your plight and your road is the road that, you know what I'm saying, was set for you, man.
Hip-hop hits, period.
This is Hip-Hop Nation.